You might recognize our last presenter from last year where you showed off Turntable, which is now an Illustrator beta. Showed that off yesterday. Yes, rock star. Well, this year he has a news surprise. Please welcome Ji Xin Chen with Project Turnstile. Welcome.
Thank you. Thank you, Paul. Thank you, everyone. Hi, Jessica.
Hi.
Okay, so it's about Halloween, so I want to design a scene with a Halloween scene. I have spent a long time working on this image asset. Now I want to put my asset into the scene. Well, it seems the viewpoint of my asset doesn't quite match with the background, and I wish I could turn the asset a little to the right, but how do I do that? You might have already noticed the 3D rotate button down here, so let me just click it and introduce Project Turnstile, which gives you complete control over the viewpoint of an image asset. After clicking the 3D rotate button, I'll get a 3D shape.
Wow. Wow.
Then I can rotate it to whatever viewpoint I want.
Wow.
I can also make it look more perspective.
Wow.
Or more orthographic. Now let's put the asset into the scene. Okay. Now you might ask, what do we do with all the blurriness and missing details? Mm-hmm. No worries. We've got that covered with another button called upscale. You see, the 3D shape here is just a proxy of the actual asset. So I can use a proxy to find the best viewpoint. After I'm happy with the viewpoint, I can use the upscale button to restore the full resolution and all the fine details.
Wow. Wow.
Very nice.
I think this one's good. Now let's compare it with the original asset. So here we have October 31st, 7 p.m. Friday night bash. The text looks correct. Then we have the skeleton. Notice that the ribs in the original asset are in front of the tombstone, but after rotation, they are in front of nothing, so you can actually see through the ribs.
Wow.
Thank you.
So we also have four pumpkins on the left and two on the right, so everything checks out. And finally, I can use image harmonization to blend my new asset nicely into the background.
So this was a sneak last year, is this harmonize button. It's, we'll make it look like it's part of that scene, which is cool.
Okay.
So there we go.
Wow.
Okay, here we go.
Bingo.
Yeah. Wow.
Now, let me show you another asset I'd like to add to the scene, a pair of kids.
That's cute.
Now, I'm going to turn them to 3D because apparently their viewpoint also doesn't match with the background. And after I have the 3D shape, I'll be able to freely adjust the camera.
Wow.
Now, I can turn them to face away,
what?
So it looks like they are walking toward the house. Or I can turn them around, so it looks like they just got their candy and they are leaving the house.
Wow.
What's in their buckets? Can we take a look at the candy?
Now let's hit upscale and see what we get.
Guess not. No candy for me.
And in the meanwhile, let me bring back the original asset so we can compare them.
That's amazing. Oh.
Okay.
There we go. There we go.
There we
I wasn't
it.
Gonna
oh,
say
yeah.
anything.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
So what candy did they get?
Face looks nice. We have got all the details on the pumpkin costumes.
Yeah.
And the face paintings on the buckets are well preserved.
Wow.
And finally, let me add some shade to the background. And I think I'm done with this scene. But we still have some time left. So let's have some fun. I'm sure most of you recognize this figure from Photoshop's bus screen. But have you ever wondered what it would look like if the bird were looking at you instead of looking to the left?
Oh yeah, let's make it scarier.
So here, I have segmented the head and turned it into a 3D shape.
Oh no, don't make it look at me.
Now I can make it whatever direction I want.
Hello.
Let me just turn it to a front-facing view and hit upscale.
Unbelievable.
Is he looking at us, or?
Love the tech, hate the bird. Love the tech, hate the bird.
All right, now the bird is looking right at you.
Oh, you get choices.
All this is made possible with product turnstile. Thank you.
Wow.
All right, buddy. Amazing.